Good morning and welcome to the first senior gig of May. We've got a whole hour of musical mayhem for you this morning, coming to you live from London.
To put a spring in your step this morning, we will provide you with the best music money can buy from the truly fantastic R.E.M. here. We've got Stephen Gately, we've got the one and only Geri Halliwell, and we've got an exclusive performance from Destiny's Child.
We'll also be having a first look at Melanie B's brand new video, and she'll be answering your email questions too. Plus, we've got a very, very special report from some of the loveliest blokes in rock, Travis.
But to start off, we've got a performance from a band that's been consistently releasing excellent records since the 1980s. They're here today with Imitation of Life. It is the truly awesome R.E.M.
You could.
from R.E.M. And make sure that you stay tuned to CD UK because they'll be performing an old classic for us exclusively. So stay tuned. We'll also be showing you Melanie B's brand new video and she'll be in the studio to answer your emails. So if you want to ask her any questions at all, then get them into us here at mail@cdukstudio.co.uk or you can fax us on 0207 737 8393. But right now, it's time for World Pop News.
Destiny's Child looks set to coin it in after signing a deal to advertise shoes and their own range of dolls.
Brooklyn Beckham looks set to make his singing debut on his mum's forthcoming solo album.
Kylie will soon be appearing on postage stamps back in Oz.
And Robbie Williams has been up to his old tricks again this week, claiming he's dating the Queen Mum.
Although Ronan Keating doesn't seem keen to get back on stage with his Boyzone bandmates, he exclusively told us he would like to perform with some other artists.
I would love to do a duet. Me and my management were just talking about it. I think it would be a really cool thing to do for me, Robbie and maybe Craig David, the three of us to get together and do a song together for something, for a charity or whatever. It would obviously be a pop song, you know, that's what it would have to be, but obviously Craig would get to have a little bit of the old hit da da bong da da bing da da bing in there and I, you know, Robbie could do a little bit of the more rockier stuff and I could fill in the pop, you know, it'd be pretty brilliant.
Manic Street Preachers are about to release their second single, Ocean Spray. We caught up with the lead singer, James Dean Bradfield, who wrote the track following the death of his mother.
I think, you know, the actual video for Ocean Spray is trying to kind of capture that kind of, like, feeling of being disconnected from events that are going on in your life. If something really bad is happening in your life, you kind of almost feel disconnected from it. You almost kind of feel as if, you know, real life slows down to a kind of almost like surreal pace.
Although the track is close to his heart, James didn't get to don the director's cap, but that could well change in the future for another member of the band.
I think, you know, myself, Nick and Sean are, definitely have that kind of bit of a frustrated kind of like director's kind of instinct inside us because we're such massive film fans. So, but I do think, you know, we're definitely frustrated film buffs, but I don't know if that makes us potential directors. I think Nick would probably have the best shot at it. Nick has had a lot of input to our videos in the past.
CD UK joined multi-platinum US rapper Nelly on the set of his new video, Ride With Me, where he was keen to set the record straight about the rumoured ongoing beef between himself and Eminem.
Me and Eminem have never came to blows. We've never had an argument. We've never came to any fisticuffs or anything. It was a slight misunderstanding that's been resolved. And his daughter's a big fan of mine, and it's all good.
2001 looks set to be the year that indie music strikes back. Coldplay have already stormed the Brits, we've seen the return of Travis, the rise of Star Sailor, and the emergence of hot new indie band Elbow. Their critically acclaimed debut release, Asleep in the Back, has just been voted Album of the Week by the NME, and they received rave reviews stateside as well.
Now then, if you were watching SMTV earlier on, you would have seen these three lovely young ladies belting out their current hit and former number one, Survivor. But as you know, we here at CDUK like to get in there first and give you the ones to watch for the future. So here they are with an exclusive album track, which could well be their next single. It's the Bootylicious, Destiny's Child.
Yeah.
child there, and I don't think I'll be risking my reputation saying that that's going to be another massive hit for Destiny's Child.
I would think so.
And you can catch that on their new album, which is currently rocking its way to the number one spot.
Lovely, lovely ladies, and they've been extra lovely and very generous to us this week because they've given us a great prize to give away to you at home. They've given us one pair of VIP tickets to Jam in the Park on the 17th of June, where the girls are going to be headlining. Now, that's good in itself, but check this out. You'll also get to meet Destiny's Child backstage, and they'll even take care of your travel and your accommodation as well.
Oh, wow.
It's a great prize. It's a great day, and Ant himself is visibly excited by the prospect.
That's a great prize.
It is a great
prize. But I can't enter.
No, you can't, but you can give them the question so they can enter.
The question is, which city did Destiny's Child come from? Is it A, London, B, Houston, or C, Sydney? Everything you know, give us a ring. 09069-111101. Calls cost 60 pence. Get permission before you call. And remember,
state the full answer. Cutty, cutty, cut, cut, where are you?
Thank you very much indeed, lads. We've got another great competition coming up a little bit later on in the show. Still to come this morning, we've got performances from Geri Halliwell, Stephen Gately and R.E.M. We'll be putting your emails to Melanie B. And we've got a very special report from Travis. We'll see you after the break.
Shut that door. It's freezing in here.
Welcome back. How do we do it? I don't know. Not only have we still got an exclusive performance of an absolute classic from R.E.M., we've also got an exclusive interview with Travis, and we've seen it, and it's worth sticking around for, let me tell you.
And if that wasn't enough, we'll also be shooting the breeze with Melanie B. And you know, you think we have time for a performance from Geri Halliwell and the Saturday Chop, but guess what we have?
Well, up next, we've got an artist who entered the CD UK Top 10 today, and we're very pleased to have him in the studio once again. In fact, we might just ask him to stay.
Nice
very
one.
Clever. Very, very clever.
It's Stephen Gately.
No.
Lovely, everybody. But now, as you can see, I've been joined by the lovely Melanie B.
Hey. Hello.
Now, you'll be answering our questions in the viewers' emails a little bit later. And we're just about to take a look at your video. But before we do, tell us a little bit about it.
Well, I did it in Morocco. And the song basically is purely about my little girl, Phoenix. So she's got little clips and documentaries, Super 8, High 8 footage
in there. She's
in
the video?
Yeah, just little bits of it.
But did she go out to, because you shot it in Morocco?
Yeah, kind of had a holiday out there with my dad and my sister, and then I did a bit of a video. I did a bit of work for 2 days.
How is she with the cameras and stuff? Does she play up to them, or is she...
She doesn't even notice they're there. And then when she does notice, she goes up to it like that. She loves it. She's really sweet.
Well, let's take a look. Would you like to introduce it for us?
Yeah. Here's my... How do I say it? Here's my new song, our new video, Lullaby.
Here it is. You've just said it. Well done.
For the dog. But I know this love is unconditional.
Yeah, yeah.
Deep inside, you're my living joy.
Yeah.
I'm singing you a lullaby 1,000 times or more. You're as sweet as a butterfly. Baby, all I need are more. Gonna sing you my song, 'cause I think
indeed. Coming up on the rest of today's show, we've got another amazing performance from R.E.M. Geri Halliwell will be reigning men. We've got that special report from Travis, and Melanie B will be sticking around to answer your emails and faxes. It's all after this break. Don't you dare go away. See you in three.
Oh, but he's a sour one. He's got a lot of bottle, though.
Hello there, and welcome back to part 3 of CD UK. Now, if you've just joined us, You've already missed two of the biggest bands in the world this morning. You've missed Destiny's Child and R.E.M. However, stick around because there will be more from Mr. Stipe & Co. in just a moment.
Looking forward to that. Melanie B is also here this morning. She's here to answer your email and fax questions. So get them into us ASAP on all of the usual addresses. Plus, we'll be catching up with Travis in rehearsals. And can I just say, how good is it to see Travis back on the scene? It's been too long. I think it's going to be their year this year.
Indeed, indeed. Now though, we've got an all-time classic from one of the biggest and best bands in the world. This track was actually released 10 years ago and it's definitely, definitely stood the test of time. We think we'll recognise this one straight away. Once again, it's R.E.M.
Of rock and roll band in the States, the Black Crowes are probably best known over here for lead singer Chris Robinson's romantic associations with movie star Kate Hudson. However, their US tour with Oasis and two summer gigs with the Stereophonics should finally bring their music to the fore.
Nearly a year after their debut single, Bam for the Reload, reached the number one slot, the duo are set to release their first album. This track precedes it by 2 weeks and sees the boys giving a taster of what to expect.
Said to me, we'll never make it weird. The second single from the number one album, Just Enough Education to Perform, sees the Phonics providing a more upbeat sound than their previous single, Mr. Writer. The boys are currently out of action for a month as Kelly's laid low with flu. But don't worry, they'll be back in June.
How do you follow up the biggest selling single so far this year? Well, like this apparently. Angel followed It Wasn't Me to the top of the US singles charts and is already getting the airplay over here, which commands a high chart placing on its release at the end of the month.
That's how you should be treated. Though you never get the loving that you needed. Could have left, but I call and you heeded. Begged and I pleaded, mission completed.
Turn up the heater.
Shug it.
I love that guy.
Right now, though, we catch up with the band who've been off the scene for a while, but are back with their brand new single, Sing. And if you ask me, are a breath of fresh air in this current music climate of sports, metal, thrash, American, metal-y, angst-ridden, metal-y kids.
It is indeed a great song. Last week we caught up with the Travis boys in their rehearsal studio to get the lowdown on what's been going on since they were last here in the CDUK studio. And this is what they had to say.
We've been away for a while. We completed touring The Man Who in LA in September and took the weekend off and went in and started recording the next record, and we've just finished it. Just tell me what it's good.
First 3 weeks we're in a studio called Ocean Way in LA, which is on Sunset Boulevard.
Has anyone got a plectrum?
Frank Sinatra recorded there. Yeah. Nat King Cole recorded Unforgettable.
And Michael Mona Jackson.
Lisa. Michael Jackson.
Thriller.
We Are the World.
We Are the World.
We recorded the videos in that studio.
I was convinced that Frank Sinatra's ghost came to me one day. I was sitting at the piano and he didn't speak to me or he didn't move anything. I started smelling this really farty smell. It was like someone had guffed right beside me and I was sitting going. I was in the studio all by myself. That's and it's kind of like a haunt. It's
Blame Frank.
It's kind of a song about just letting go. You know, you look at kids and everything and they just sing all the time and they laugh and they cry and they do all these extreme things. When you're in a band, like directors who want to make a video for the band give you this bit of paper that sort of outlines what their idea is, and that's called a treatment. And the first line in this was, there's nothing more satisfying in life than a great big pie in your face. We kind of like that, and they said at the bottom of the treatment, they go, this video is completely, has nothing to do with the lyrics of the song, but it has an expression of the song of just like letting go and just totally going for it.
The video was like the most fun we've ever had making a video. It was like a 3-day shoot, which is usually pretty hard work, but it was just hilarious. I mean, a lot of it was quite sort of scripted, you know, a lot of this, you see people getting pies in their faces and it's quite sort of, they planned it ahead and it's just one guy and four guys standing around them with like sort of pies in their hand like that.
Directors took bits. We looked at all the classic food fights like Blazing Saddles and The Three Stooges, The Great Race, and
The Party.
The Party with Peter Sellers. And like, they took all these little bits out of it and like put them all into one sort of food fight. For the love you bring
won't mean a thing. Recommend everybody to have a food fight at some point this week. Yeah. At least try and start one. It's brilliant fun. It's a total release.
It's a good song to come back with for us because having done all the shows, and that's the one thing we always come away with, just people singing. It's like some bands you come away and you go stage surfing or stage diving, and their shows, it's usually singing. We're doing is Reading and Leeds and Glasgow, which is great. Glasgow Green. Have you ever been to Glasgow Green?
The first concert, like the sort of free concert I went to, was in Glasgow Green. It was like called Big Day Out.
Oh yeah.
And it was amazing. It was just like sort of, like, so I've got sort of fond memories of being in Glasgow Green, watching Big Country, I think it was.
The funniest things happening on stage are
been me like, falling off it.
Yeah, Andy fell off stage one
in Germany
one time, and none of us knew that he'd gone.
Bless him, he kept playing.
He was still playing.
I was lying on my back, and like one of these, I landed in one of these boxes like that, on my back, and I was like lying on my back, like trying to play, and like as well, the roadies like lifted me up and put me back on stage.
And then his little head just popped up. Like, that
very spinal shock.
Excited to be back. It's going to be great. I can't wait to see 6-7.
Hey, 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 I say, hey, ho. And I'm so
Top Boys, we like them a lot. Travis, they're back with the first single from their forthcoming album entitled The Invisible Band. And you can see them perform Sing very live.
It will be very live.
Here on CDK very soon is what I meant to say.
And a little bit more information for you because we've got a fantastic prize for you now. When Travis do come down to the studio on May the 19th, you could spend the day with them. Yes, you can spend the day with the band. We pay your travel and accommodation.
That's not too shabby, that. What's the catch?
There's no catch. All you've got to do is answer this question. Who's the lead singer of Travis? Is it A, Frank Zappa, B, Fran Healy, or C, Frank Kenstein? Call us on 90690111101. Calls cost 60 pence. Please get permission. And remember, state the full answer.
Come and look. What's down here? Come and look. What's down here? It's the lovely cat.
Hello. Still to come on this morning's show, we're going to be putting your email questions to Melanie B. And we'll also be finding out if S Club 7 are still at the top of the charts or if they've been toppled by Geri Halliwell or Jennifer Lopez. All that to come. Stay right where you are. We'll see you after the break.
Shut that door, it's freezing in here.
We've now been joined by Melanie B.
Hi.
Hello, guys. Now, we've had loads of emails. Right. Not a lot of time. Let's dive straight in.
Kate Bremner from Staffordshire. It's a good one, this. I don't know if I should ask it. Do you think you scare men?
No. No asshole.
Do you not? You don't think you do?
Nope. I'm just very open and very loving and very honest.
Because I'm quivering here. I'm a quivering
wreck. No, you're not.
Do you think you're quite intimidating, though, of men? Or
do people think you are? Do you think you're going to be when they
meet you? I think some people might have a preconception in their head as to what I'm like, because I'm very outspoken and I speak my mind, but that's just the way I am. I don't do it to hurt people unless somebody really gets on my nerves.
Is that the Leeds lass in you, though?
That's the Northern Council estate bird in me.
Why not? Like don't that. Stop it.
My type of girl.
We've got one here from Lynn Fraser from Cardiff. She says, why did you decide to release a song about Phoenix when you've always said you wanted to keep her out of the public eye?
Well, the thing is, when I came to writing my album, I always knew I wanted to write a song about my daughter because she's my life.
Yeah.
And my album is everything that's happened to me in the past, in the present, you know, so it was just a natural thing for me to do, really.
Mm.
And it's not, I mean, it's not as if you're using her to court it because it's written especially about her.
No, it's just about her. Yeah. I mean, I would be missing out a big part of my life if I didn't involve her in my writing. I can't help it.
And it's not the first time that anybody's ever wrote a song about their children, really, is it, either?
I know.
Strange. Oh, listen. What are you laughing?
When are you two gonna have babies?
It's physically impossible.
What do you know with your lovely ladies?
Oh, I see. Oh, I thought you meant together, like little lantern deck babies.
Not for a while.
Not for
we
a while.
Create an army.
God,
I think you should. I think you'd be good dads.
Oh, bless you.
Thank you.
Lucy Ball from Doncaster, let's move swiftly on. I'm a big Spice Girls fan and I was really upset when Mel C implied it was all over. What's happening? Are you or aren't you?
No, but she didn't imply it was all over.
Mm. She was called,
we're not over either. We're all doing our own little individual bits. But we are still very, very solid as a group, very.
How did the press get a hold of that? How did they get to blow that all over?
How did they write what they write in the first place? The only thing that you can believe is the date on the top of the paper, I think. The rest of the stuff that's inside is all really, really exaggerated.
And does it not bother you now? Do you just let it sort of wash over your head?
It does bother me a little bit, but I just think, oh, it's fish and chip paper tomorrow, isn't it?
Yeah, exactly.
And I love fish and chips.
And saveloys.
Oh, no. No? Not fast saveloys.
No? Oh, well, you're missing
very
out.
Very dodgy.
You can't beat a nice battered sausage.
I've got one here from Jennifer Wright.
You're really rude. I was told I wasn't allowed to do any innuendos or rudeness. And all throughout the show, you've been giving all these comments. Don't you think so?
I don't know what you're on about. I'm talking about going to the chimmy.
You just said nothing like
that. Don't you listen.
Last weekend you appeared at the South Africa Freedom Concert in London.
Oh.
And Nelson Mandela was there, guest of honour. Is he one of your heroes?
Oh, I thought there was an accident.
No, that's coming next.
No. Is he one of your all-time heroes?
He is amazing, absolutely. He's just an amazing person, what he's been through.
Yeah.
It's brilliant. And that show was actually celebrating the 7 years of democracy. I haven't taught now. So it was really good to be involved in it.
But you've met him before, like all the Spice Girls met him before.
Yeah.
And last time you met him, you took a little souvenir, didn't you?
Toilet roll.
From his house?
I nicked some toilet roll, yeah.
Have you still got it, or have you used it?
Yeah, it's in a little plastic bag.
Is it?
Yeah.
Lovely.
Am I insane?
No, it's good. It's very nice indeed. Listen, thank you for...
I can't help nicking things.
Don't say that. The police have been here by
half 12. From shows and things. Right. Not from shows.
Listen, thank you for coming down. You've hung yourself. It's Melanie B, everybody.
But now, let's go to the camp. Oh, we can.
Club 7 have stopped moving and they're still at the top of the charts, or if Geri Halliwell and Jennifer Lopez have managed to topple them. It's the CD UK Saturday Chart Rundown, numbers 10 to 2.
At 10, you saw him earlier on the show, it's Stephen Gately. She's just announced a one-off date in London at the end of the month. Missy Elliott is at 9.
Currently loving each day on his UK tour at 8. It's Ronan Keating.
You saw their stunning performance of Bootylicious earlier on Destiny's Child, or at 7. Halliwell falls two places to this week's number six.
R.E.M. opened the show earlier. They're a new entry at five.
M.O.P. are as cold as ice at four. She's just signed a £7 million deal to create her own line of clothing and free. It's Jennifer Lopez.
They released their new album in October. S Club 7 are at two.
So there you go, S Club 7 haven't made it 2 weeks at the top, which means a brand new number one. Before that, who's on next week?
Tune in at 10:30 next week. We've got Mel B, Nelly and the Divine Comedy all on the show.
It's going to be a good show. Now then, this next lady is no stranger to the top spot, having been there seven times with her old band, three times as a solo artist, and I'm sure she's going to enjoy it all over again this time, isn't she?
Yes, indeed. This version has fared slightly better than the one out at the moment. With It's Raining Men, Geri Halliwell is the brand new CDK Saturday chart. Number one. See you next week.
Bye.
Happy Mom!